Life in the ocean is not evenly spread. It's regulated by the path of currents carrying nutrients and the varying power of the sun. In this first program, we will see how these two forces interact to control the distribution of life from the coral seas to the polar wastes. The sheer physical power of the ocean dominates our planet. It profoundly influences the weather of all the world. Water vapor rising from it forms the clouds and generates the storms that ultimately will drench the land. That roar in towards the shores are dramatic demonstrations of its power. Waves originate far out at sea. There, even gentle breezes can cause ripples, and ripples grow into swells. Impeded by land, such swells can become gigantic. It's only when an ocean swell eventually reaches shallow water that it starts to break. As it approaches the coast, the water at the bottom of the swell is slowed by contact with the seabed. The top of the swell, still traveling fast, starts to roll over, and so the wave breaks. The ocean never rests. Huge currents, such as the Gulf Stream, keep its waters constantly on the move all around the globe. It's these currents, more than any other factor, that control the distribution of nutrients and life in the seas. A tiny island lost in the midst of the Pacific. It's the tip of a huge mountain that rises precipitously from the seafloor thousands of meters below. The land is 300 miles away. Isolated sea mounts like this one create oases where life can flourish in the comparatively empty expanses of the open ocean. Creatures that swim beside it would not be here were it not for one key factor. The deep ocean currents. Far below the surface